Hey, I'm Ross with Sky Management, and it is a bright sunny day out here. So today I wanted to try to figure out how to install a solar pool heater. I'm going to be doing a commercially made one, and my brother's going to do kind of a redneck version. So we're going to see which one works better. I got this one on Amazon, and I'll include a link down below to this particular one. This is one of the larger ones that they sold on Amazon. So it's a 5-foot by 20-foot solar collector. It does not come with all of the hoses and stuff to hook it up, so we'll just have to see what we need once we get it all laid out. The kit comes with two sections that are 20 feet long. The water will go into one section and run down like these two, down to the other end, and then it's going to go into the other section and run down to the other end and back to the pool. And it also came with an in and an out pipe that I'm gonna have to get hoses that will go on these, plus some clamps. And that's what came in the kit. My pool was originally set up with a Polaris vacuum system. That's this extra pump here. This is the main pool pump. And then this is like an extra pump that ran water out of here and into there. That powered the Polaris vacuum, and it has a timer already up here. So I'm going to try to use this to pump water through my solar collector instead of running directly off of the pump. I'm gonna try that first. That way I can be able to shut it on and off with the timer. If that doesn't work, then you can tap into the line that's going to your pool and run off of that. So like mine already has one here. And I'll run it from there, and it'll go through the collector and out there the same as it would a jet into the pool. The difference being I wouldn't be able to turn it off. It would be just run all the time. So it'd be ideal to only have it running during the day. With my solar collector being 5 feet wide and 20 feet long, it's gonna be very awkward to move around. So I've decided I'm gonna build a frame for it out of PVC pipe. So that'll be our first step. My frame built out of PVC, it's not going to be super sturdy, but hopefully two people can kind of carry it over to the side of the house where it needs to be and then be able to put it away in the wintertime and whatnot. So now I'm going to secure the solar collector to the frame with some zip ties. So looking at this, water's gonna go in one side and out the other, so this side won't be connected together in the middle. They'll be plugged here and here, and then open on the ends. So this cap comes off. And then on the other end, so the water will be coming in these top ones, and then it's gonna transfer over right here. So you have to connect the far side into the other tube, and it's going to go back the other way, and then we will cap both ends of this far side. To get my input and output over to a 3/4 inch PEX line, I'm going to use a Fernco on there down to a PVC 3/4 inch threaded, and then the PEX adapter, and it will look like this, and then I'll be able to attach my PEX line right there and run it into the pump. To attach the solar collector into the pump system, you'll have to come off of where this is the line that goes out to all the jets in the pool, and this has a teed off piece that went over to my Polaris pump. Well, I'm going to hook the Polaris pump back into that. So the water will come out of the pool through this pump, will run out
to the solar collector, run through the solar collector, and then come back in to here. So I will have to connect a 3/4 inch PEX adapter in here to bring it back in. And I will have to add a PEX adapter to this side in order to go out to the collector.
I spent the last hour and a half or so plumbing everything together. So it's, as it stands, the water's coming in off the pool, going through the Polaris pump, out to the collector, and then back into this single jet that shoots out in the middle of the pool where the Polaris cleaner would have gone. So far, I'm going to have to rework it because I found out that this pump leaks a lot, all this water out here on the floor. But it pushed a lot of water out of there, probably more than is necessary. So I think what I'm going to do is just remove the pump and hook this one up over here and see how much water flow I get. I've run out of my pump and around the corner because I didn't want to have to look at the collector all the time, so I've run it around to the side of my house. Now, I wish, the downside of this thing is I wish it came with a frame to put it on, so I had to build one, and it's, once I got it up upright like that and it got water in it, it got heavier, so all the things started sagging a little bit. So they make it look all pretty in the picture when you're buying one of these things, but this is what it looks like if you try to stand it up like this. I think it would work better if it was laying down, so I may have to, I've got some pallets, I may lay them out here on the ground and then lay it down so that it's just facing straight up and laying out flat. That would probably be better. So I may try to do that, but this is how it turned out. I have my pump running right now. Without having an additional pump to just pump water specifically through this, it doesn't move a whole lot of water, but there's still a decent amount coming out of there. So I will test what's coming out of there and see how well it's working out. For my initial startup, the water going in is about 67 degrees, and it's 10 o'clock in the morning right now, and it's only 65 degrees outside, so I'm gonna see what's coming out of there. The sun is hitting my solar collector full right now, even though it's only 65 degrees outside. It's taking it up to 74, looks like. So we're going from 67 to 74 right now, but it's only 10 o'clock in the morning. We'll check it again this afternoon. Okay, it is now 3 o'clock in the afternoon, the same day, so the sun is shining full, so let's see how well it's working now.
It's 78 degrees today, so it's a fairly warm day, but it got the water up to 84 coming out of there, so I would say that it is working.
So the takeaways from the Doheny solar pool heater, the collector works really well. It is bulky and it doesn't come with a frame, but the collector itself actually transfers heat pretty well. So the downsides are you have to build your own frame, and you have to build something fairly sturdy because of how large it is. If you can get it where you want it and have it set up, then it does exchange heat pretty well and put out a decent amount of heat. The other problem is plumbing it in. I'm lucky and I had a Polaris line run into my pool, so I don't have to run hoses out across the deck or anything. If you didn't have that advantage already, then you'd have to tap into the jet line the same as I did, and then you'd have to just run a hose into the pool because you can't tap it back into the jet line again because there's no way to get the water to circulate around that way. So does it work? Yeah, it works. I do like the collector itself. Just know that you're gonna have to build a frame and have a way to plumb it in. So if you follow the instructions the way I did it, then it works pretty good.